The seven last words of Jesus are words that can inspire and strengthen us in our faith. And today we're focusing on the first of those last seven words where Jesus says, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." So if you had never encountered Christianity or Catholicism before, and you walked into a room and saw a crucifix, saw an image of a man nailed to a cross, and you asked a Christian, a Catholic, what does this mean? What is this all about? It would be interesting to hear what their response would be. And probably one of the first things that they would say is what's happening on the cross is God is forgiving our sins. Because when we talk about Christianity, we talk about Catholicism, we talk about following Jesus, at the very heart and center of our faith is this concept of forgiveness, that we have done something wrong. We have trespassed. We have transgressed a relationship with God, a relationship with one another, and that we are in need of forgiveness. So when we look at the cross, we look at Jesus on the cross, the words that Jesus speaks to us and the words that Jesus speaks in Luke 23, verse 34 is, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." That Jesus looks at our sins against him, the ways that we have done violence to him, and his response, God's response, is not hatred, is not condemnation, but it is actually forgiveness, and it is actually the full flowering of what we call God's love for us. And I think that is really important that when we're hearing Jesus' last words, the first of these last words of Jesus, the first phrase that Jesus utters from the cross is, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." So I think this is really important for us that this should change the way, if we appreciate that and ponder that, the way that we view those who have wronged us, because you probably have people in your life that have hurt you, that have hurt you, maybe hurt people that you love. And think about all the ways that we can harbor unforgiveness or resentment or even hatred towards those people who have hurt us. But if we're looking at Jesus and our eyes are fixed on Jesus and seeing him forgive us, then that necessarily overflows into the way that we are supposed to view other people. That we are supposed to look at people and even the ones that have hurt us and forgive them. Speak those same words with Jesus, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do." So with Jesus as our model, what happens as he forgives us, that the wounds that we have inflicted upon him now become places of grace, places of healing and mercy. And so if we internalize that, then when we forgive someone else, that place that was just a wound, was just a place that hurt and was painful and was dark, maybe something that we wanted to move away from, now if we open it up to forgiveness, becomes potentially a place of healing, a place of mercy, a place of grace. And so even the darkest places of our lives, we open them up to the mercy of God, which is opened up completely and totally on the cross. It has the potential to be a place of profound transformation. I think of in my own life, in my family, where a family member had experienced tremendous hurt and pain from his father, that when he was able to finally forgive his father, that became a source of healing and grace for all the other family members. That every other family member who was negatively impacted by that wound now began to be impacted in a positive way. There's a great line in scripture where it says that where sin abounds, grace abounds all the more. And this happens in a particular way on the cross. That all the sin and shame and darkness of the cross that Jesus has taken upon himself, it now becomes transformed into something that we would call grace, which is the love of God poured out because Jesus desires to forgive. So today, as we hear those words from Jesus that he speaks over us, you and your worst sin, that when you look upon Jesus on the cross, he's not condemning you, he's not rejecting you, that Jesus is looking upon you with love and forgiving you. And he's pouring out the Father's forgiveness upon us as well. So we ponder today those first words from Jesus from the cross, "Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do."